trash. Rotten, awful, bummer, terrible, no good, crummy, terrible, awful, terrible, bummer. Ugh.
Hi, Scooter, how are you?
Okay.
You don't seem okay. I mean, you seem kind of depressed.
Well, it's just old school.
Ah! You flunked! What'd you flunk? Arithmetic? Reading? Recess? Huh? Huh? What'd you flunk? Did you flunk?
No, I did not flunk. It's just Miss Gallagher.
Oh, her.
Yeah, she is our worst teacher. I mean, I know we spend all day at school. She expects us to do homework, too.
Ah! She's gonna make you do a book report.
Hey, that's incredible. How'd you know that?
'Cause I got the old shaft, too.
Oh, what'd you have to read?
Cinderella.
Oh, well, at least you lucked out. I mean, everybody knows that story. I mean, you probably already read the book.
Well, no, but I saw the movie.
Oh, well, I got a real good one. Ivanhoe.
Ivan who?
Ivanhoe.
Who's he?
I don't know, but with a name like that, boy, he's got to be a bummer.
That's true. Have you read it yet?
No.
Well, when's the report due?
Tomorrow.
You mean Miss Gallagher expects you to read a whole book and write a whole book report in one day?
Not exactly.
What do you mean?
Well, she gave us the assignment last week.
Oh, that's funny. She gave us our assignment 2 weeks ago.
Really? Well, that's not fair. You get 2 weeks. I mean, when's your book report due?
Last week.
Oh, you missed it, huh?
Well, it's no big deal. I'll just tell her our dog chewed up my paper and I had to start all over again.
But we don't have a dog.
Well, she doesn't know that.
Well, why haven't you written it yet?
Well, I get started. I mean, I do a little writing here and a little writing there. And then something comes up and, well, you know.
Yeah, I sure do. I mean, she only gives us some kind of thing like that to do when I have batting practice or we have a game or something.
Yeah, teachers have lousy timing.
That's true. Well, I guess I better get started.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I kind of have an idea of what I'm gonna write. It was this poor girl.
Maybe I could start mine. There was this poor guy. I'm gonna go get my pencil.
This program will continue following these announcements.
Thank you.
now back to our program.
Okay, let's see. All right. Ivanhoe was a knight.
Scooter!
Who?
Scooter.
Hi, Dusty.
Hi.
Rode
what?
A big horse.
Scooter.
Yes.
I have to tell you something.
Ivanhoe was a knight who rode a big horse.
He rode, okay. Well, I know wait a minute. I know Ivanhoe was
you
a knight
do?
Who rode a horse. Yeah.
You know the story?
Oh, of course I do.
How would you like to tell me in capsule form?
How would you like to go on a trip?
That's better.
Do you remember?
I
told you I was trying to arrange a trip because I know how much you like ketchup, so I thought we would find out how they make...
I love ketchup on French fries.
Okay, well, I thought we would go find out how they make ketchup, so...
Okay.
Can you go?
Sure.
What is this? What is this you're working on?
Oh, it's nothing.
Are you
it's
sure?
It's nothing important. It's just a little old book report.
Oh, just a little book report. Oh, are you sure you don't have to get it done?
No, it didn't have to be for like 100 long time.
Well, okay then. Come on, let's
okay.
go. I'll race you over to the balloon.
Wait!
Let me open the door for you. Come on.
I'm in.
Are you in?
Yep. Oops,
watch out.
Ow.
Okay. Be careful. Oh, boy. Well, today we're going to take a trip to Hunt's Ketchup to find out how they're making ketchup. Let's go! Okay. See?
Yep.
Okay. Here we are in the tomato field. Of course, they grow tomatoes on vines. And when they're all nice and red and ripe, then they have to harvest them. And they harvest them between July and September in a three-month period. And here's the special harvester that rides along and picks up the tomatoes. It's a lot of tomatoes, isn't it, Scooter?
Boy, it sure is.
And they ride along this conveyor belt, the vines and all. Now here, notice what they're doing. They're shaking the vines as they go along, shaking off the... And here the workers are going through the tomatoes, and if there are any that have bad spots on them, then they throw them out. They're checking all the tomatoes. A lot of tomatoes, a whole carload there. Look at that. And now they're off to the processing plant. First, what they want to do is take a sample, call it a random sample. So they dig down in the middle and they take out a sampling of tomatoes. Quality control, it's making sure that all the tomatoes, as many of the tomatoes as they can possibly guess at, are really good tomatoes. So, taking a sample. Usually you take a sample when you can't go through every single thing. In this case, tomatoes. They can't go through every single little itty-bitty tomato, so they take a sampling just to make sure they have good tomatoes. Millions of tomatoes. Checking them. Only the best ones put in for ketchup. Going overhead, blocking out the sun. Now this is really interesting. You know, most of us ride in a car if we want to go somewhere, or on a bus, or on a bicycle. Well, these tomatoes ride on water. And what they do is they pour in this water. Now you notice the water might be a little brown when you see it. Well, that's because they use it over and over again. And this is only used to make the tomatoes travel. So they sort of ride by water. And then
they go through a bathing process where they're all washed off. It's very, very clean water. And they're getting their bath. Here they're examined again. There's a lot of checking that goes into this. Making sure only the best tomatoes become ketchup. When you see a bottle of ketchup, it's hard to believe it all came from all those tomatoes. And here they get cooked. This great big cooker. Great big vat to cook the tomatoes, and sugar, salt, spices, and vinegar are added to the tomatoes to give ketchup its flavor. And here, the bottles get washed also, and everything has to be very clean. And then, after they're washed and dried, they get filled. Parade of the ketchup. And all those bottles are automatically loaded into cartons like this. And then they're shipped off to a store near your house. And that's how they do it. That's how the ketchup gets into the bottle.
Can I have that on some french fries?
I think that you might just do that, because it's almost time to eat anyway.
Good. Race you back to the table.
Okay. I'm not going to make it.
I beat.
You sure did.
Where have you been?
Hi, Maxine. How are you? We just went on a trip, and we saw ketchup was made.
Oh, isn't that wonderful?
Well, it was really interesting. Mm.
You mean you finished already?
Well,
Wait a minute. Hold it. Finished what?
Didn't you tell him?
Well, you have a big mouth. You know that.
Well, I didn't know.
Scooter?
Hi.
Scooter?
Yes.
Is something wrong? You look a little pale.
Shh. Don't you have to go get dinner or something?
Yeah. Well, all right, I'll get dinner. Are you sure you're okay?
I'm all right.
All right.
Bye. Boy, are you gonna get it? I'm gonna whack you on the head with a limb off the tree.
I don't know why you're being so awful. I mean, obviously, you are in the wrong.
I'm not in the wrong so much as I'm not in the right. Well, anyway.
Yeah, anyway, you don't have a book report. You should have been here.
I beg your pardon?
Oh.
Book this report, did I hear? Don't.
I'm really sorry about that.
Don't
you should
have
be.
Book report.
I was supposed to do a book report,
mm-hmm.
and but it's really not due for a while, like I told you.
Oh, a long while. You said 100 million years.
Tomorrow. Morning.
Scooter,
tomorrow
why did
morning.
You lie to me? Why didn't you tell me the truth?
Well,
we could have set the trip for later on after you finished your book report. All you had to do was tell me that.
Sort of started to tell you, and I thought, well,
but you
why
know that
spoil
I'm
your... Dusty's
now,
fun
you know
by
that...
having boy.
You know I'm your friend. You know that.
Yes.
And I would completely understand and make other arrangements for a little later.
Does that mean you're going to help me with my book report?
That means that you are going to help yourself with your book report.
I kind of thought that's what
yes, it meant. And yes. I think you might start right now.
Now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Maxine.
Yes, dear.
How about you too?
I was just starting.
Oh, I'll bet. Open thy
How do you spell Cinderella?
C-I-N-D-E-R-E-L-L-A, and open your beak.
I have to get a glass of water.
You will open
your
beak.
Hey, maybe I should run down a library and see if there's a condensed version.
I think it would be just a marvelous idea if both of you turned around to your pieces of paper and Scooter, Maxine, we'll be right back.
Ivanhoe.
This program will continue following these announcements. Our program.
Well, Scooter and Maxine are working on their book reports, and it's about time that they got it done. You know, there's a saying that goes, don't put off for tomorrow what you can do today.
If there's anything we didn't need, it was a platitude.
I hear you, Maxine. Now just get back to work, okay?
I'm working.
All right. And when you're done, then we'll talk, okay?
Okay.
All right.
All right.
As soon as you get an assignment, you should start on it right away. Start right that very day, and maybe do it in little pieces if you want to, until it's completed. And when it's completed, it won't have been a big rush. But if you wait to the last minute, you just get all nervous and excited, and then it doesn't come out right.
Tell me about it.
You know, Maxine. Well, while they're working, I want to tell you a story. This little story was written by Hans Christian Andersen, and it's about a pen and an inkwell, and how they were fighting all the time as to who was better and who did all the work, instead of thinking as a team. The pen and the inkwell.
Once upon a time, there was a glass inkwell and a pen made from a goose quill. The pen had been dyed a bright pink, and his pointy nib was made of the shiniest of metals. And he considered himself to be a very handsome fellow. And as for the inkwell, well, she thought her rounded curves were quite near perfection. Now, the pen and the inkwell lived in a house of a writer and sat on the desk where the young man wrote beautiful poems and wonderful stories. One day, the writer happened to remark,
"How amazing it is that all those stories I write come from that little inkwell. I wonder what'll come from it next."
Then he laughed. And picking up his gloves, he left to attend a violin concert in the city. But after a while, the inkwell, who had heard the young man's remark, began to think to herself.
what that young man said was true. It is amazing that all those wonderful stories and poems could come out of me. I really am quite extraordinary. Imagine, from me springs lovely poetry, the greatest of which, the deepest of feelings. I must really be something special. It's amazing how wonderful I am.
Yeah? Well, it's amazing how stupid you are. You can't even think. If you could, you could realize that you're just full of ink. That's all, ink. In fact, the only reason you exist at all is so that I may write all those beautiful stories on paper. I mean, after all, I'm the one who writes. All you do is sit there and look dumb.
Poor child. You haven't had much experience yet. Do you really believe that you are the poet?
Of course I am.
No, my dear. You are only the servant of the little worker. In fact, you are my servant. And, as a matter of fact, I've had many, many pens serving me before you ever came along. Why, I can't even count the numbers that have been just worn out in no time at all.
Why, you old ink tub?
You skinny feather.
Ah, oh, that was a magnificent concert.
Why, to make a violin sound like that, it was magic. It seemed as if the violin were singing. And the violinist made it seem so simple and easy. It was almost as if that wooden violin and the bow could play by themselves. Now that would make an interesting story. It could be about a violinist who was so great that his violin and bow began to believe that they were the ones who made the music.
Just like you think you write the stories.
Well, I do write them. And not you.
You.
And still, have I not often flattered myself by thinking that I alone am responsible for writing my stories?
Irresponsible?
Why, I'm no more responsible than my pen and my inkwell are responsible.
What?
Well, it's true they contribute their efforts, but it is from a higher power that our inspiration comes. Why, man should be grateful that he is blessed with the ability to create music and stories, but he should never forget from whence this blessing comes. And if I thought you two could hear me, I'd say that you should remember it too.
But the pen and the inkwell did hear. And finally, they understood.
Cinderella and the prince were married and lived happily ever after in a big apartment house with three bathrooms. I didn't know they did that.
Now,
I sort of made that up.
We're done!
Yeah, you're done?
Yes!
All right, let me have a look.
Did they really have three bathrooms?
See, I don't know. I have to kind of fix things up.
Maxine.
It's an adaptation.
Well, you shouldn't just be adding things.
Well.
She asked for a book report.
Nearly artistic verisimilitude intended to give some kind of color to an otherwise bald and unconvincing narrative.
They both look very nice.
I worked hard on mine, boy, and that weren't easy.
Okay, there are a couple of misspelled words, but I'll give those to you in a little bit, and we'll straighten it out.
How's
okay?
Mine?
Now, yours is beautiful, Maxine. Now, listen, I have a special treat for both of you, okay?
What?
Since you got your book reports done, you didn't procrastinate, you didn't wait too long, and it's Bill Jackson and Painting on Air. Watch.
We're going to have a painting on air today, and it's all about smiles.
Sometimes
Smiling is what it makes you feel like, and smiling is what you probably feel like after finishing your reports. Now say goodbye to everybody.
Goodbye to everybody.
It's time to go. Bye-bye, everyone. Thank you for being with us today. We enjoyed having you.
You can read mine again if you want.
Okay, and I'll give you the spelling. La 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 la.